Camp Holiday. I'm so excited that you guys are joining me today. On our virtual field trip. Are you ready? I hope so. I think we have some fun and exciting things underwater. So let's get ready. But first, there's just a few things that we need before we get started. First thing,
how many goggles today
to go underwater to see some
animals?
And then if you have a beach towel, you need a beach towel to dry off once you're all done. And if you want to bring any other beach gear to this trip, you're more than welcome. But last but not least, you must be ready to explore and have fun. Are you ready now? Okay, let's get started. The first sea animal that we will visit underwater is a dolphin. But first, let's learn some interesting facts about dolphins. There's five interesting facts that we're going to review today before we jump into the water with the dolphins. Number one, dolphins are believed to be very intelligent. That's pretty cool that they're smart. Dolphins are also carnivores, which means they like to eat meat. Number three, the killer whale is actually a type of dolphin. Number four, dolphins use a blowhole on the top of their heads to breathe. Sometimes you may see dolphins sprouting water from the blowhole. And number five, dolphins communicate with each other by making clicking sounds, whistling, and other cool sounds. So make sure you have your listening ears on so you can hear the sounds the dolphins make. Now, are you guys ready? Okay, don't forget to wear your goggles. Let's dive in. Pretty cool. I think I really like them. So far, they're my favorite. What about you? Did you enjoy watching the dolphins? Me too. Can you guess what's next? Okay, if you chose sharks, you're right. It's time to visit the sharks. But first, we must remember to be very, very careful, okay? And we also need to review our five interesting facts about sharks. Number one, a baby shark is referred to as a pup, like a dog. That's pretty cool. Number two, sharks do not have a single bone in their bodies. Instead, they have skeleton made up of cartilage, the same type of tough, flexible tissue that makes up the human ears and nose. A shark always has a row of smaller teeth developing behind its front teeth. Eventually, the smaller teeth will move forward and the front teeth will fall out. I've noticed that. Sometimes when I look and see the shark's teeth, it looks like it's a lot of teeth. So that explains it. Sharks have outstanding hearing. They can hear a fish thrashing in the water from as far as 500 meters away. Wow, that's far. And last but not least, number five. Sharks also have a great sense of smell. If a shark was put into a large swimming pool, it would be able to smell just a single drop of blood in the water. Ooh, that sounds scary. Okay, are you guys ready to dive in? Let's go. Nice, we're in the Bahamas now. Pretty fun, pretty cool, but a little bit scary. But I enjoyed seeing the sharks. On this dive, we have a friend that will join us to share interesting facts about these three awesome sea animals, which is the sea turtle, the stingray, and the jellyfish. Are you guys ready to listen and learn more about these three awesome sea animals? I am. Make sure you have your listening ears on and ready to learn and explore underwater. Let's dive in.
You will hardly find a person who would not enjoy the serene sound of the sea. Air Panda Team enjoys diving with marine creatures as well. Our video will show the beauty and the grace of the turtle, the jellyfish, and the stingray. Sea turtles. Several species of turtles inhabit the sea, including the hawksbill sea turtle. This animal is easily distinguished from other sea turtles by its sharp, curving beak. This reptile lives in the waters of the Atlantic and the Indo-Pacific region, but its population is low, so the International Union for Conservation of Nature has classified it as critically endangered. adult sea turtles spend all their lives in the sea and come out of water only for breeding. During this period, female turtles make a long way through the ocean to get to the nesting beaches. The archipelago of Los Jardines de la Reina, located in Cuba, is one of these places. Hawksbills lay eggs once in 2 years and make 2 or 4 clutches containing from 70 to 180 round eggs, each being 40 millimeters in diameter. Baby turtles hatch out 60 days later. The gender of the turtles depends on the temperature. Females are formed in a warmer sand. When baby turtles are born, they have a 2.5 centimeter long shell and weigh no more than 24 grams. 20 years later, they grew up to 1 meter long and gain up to 80 kilos of weight. Rays. There are more than 600 species of rays known to science. They inhabit all the seas and oceans, including the Arctic and Antarctic ones. Rays have special organs generating electric current. Some species of rays are dangerous for people as their current is strong enough to stun humans, while the Dizziatis species can even cause painful wounds. Jellyfish. Its genus name, Medusa, has come from the name of Medusa in Greek mythology, alluding to her tentacled head. Jellyfish are effective hunters as their bodies are well suited for capturing prey. They can catch everything with long tentacles, plankton, insect larvae, crustaceans, small fish and squids, while the poison from nematocysts makes their prey helpless. Jellyfish are one of the most ancient inhabitants of the planet. They have roamed the seas for at least 500 or even 700 million years.
Wow, that was really cool and a lot of interesting facts about the jellyfish, the sea turtle, and the stingray. Okay, guys, we have come to our last dive of the day, which is to check in with the octopus. I'm sure there will be some interesting facts about them. Are you guys ready? Okay, let's review our 5 interesting facts about octopus. Number 1, there are around 300 species of octopus, usually located in tropical ocean waters. Number 2, octopuses have very good eyesight, an excellent sense of touch. That's interesting. I think all of the sea animals that we learned about today usually had very good eyesight and hearing, but this is the first time that we are learning about one that has a great sense of touch. Number 3, a female octopus can lay an average of about 200,000 eggs. Whoa, that is a lot. Number 4, octopuses can squeeze into tight spaces as they have no skeleton. That's interesting and pretty cool. Can you imagine squeezing into a tight space? No, we can't do that because we have a lot of bones. Number 5, an octopus has a hard beak, like a parrot beak, which they use to break into and eat their prey, such as crabs and shellfish. Okay, are we ready to take this dive to learn more about the octopus? Okay, let's get ready. Okay, so one more interesting fact about octopuses is that they have a main defense against predators such as sharks is to hide and camouflage. So that means that we may not be able to see them because they use their certain skin cells to change its colors to blend in with things that surround them. So you guys got to look very carefully and closely, because we could be looking at the octopus right now, but we might not realize it because it's in camouflage. Do you see it yet? Keep your eyes on open. Something else that's interesting about octopuses is that they are believed to be highly intelligent. So they're very smart with hiding from us, clearly, because we don't see them yet. Let's keep looking. Whoa, I think we found them. We found the octopus. You see? When octopus hide and change the skin cells, the color of the skin cells, this can also be used to talk with each other. So that's pretty cool. And octopuses also can eject a thick blackish ink in a large cloud to distract the predator while they make a fast escape. Kind of like what he's doing now, but he didn't eject the black ink, the cloud of black ink, but he is making a fast escape and he's trying to hide from us. Oh, wow, that's a pretty cool camouflage right there. That's a good one. That's pretty neat how he's just blending in with his surroundings. And the other fish are just swimming on by. So cool. Okay, should we go back and look at him some more? See how long he's gonna hide out right there? Yeah, I bet we were looking at him as soon as we first dived in, but we may not have realized it. We first took our dive in, I bet he was sitting there. Oh, he's on the move again. Ah, and now he's changing his mind and going right back into his camouflage. I don't know, guys. This might be one of my favorites, too. The octopus may be one of my favorites. I'm torn. We were able to see the octopus, jellyfish, sharks, and many other cool sea animals. Did he finally get away from us? I think so. But we get to see all the other different fish in the water. A lot of them. I think I see the octopus again. It's all the way down there at the bottom. All righty. I hope you guys had fun today snorkeling and learning about the different sea animals. See you soon on our next adventure with Camp Holiday. You know what? I'm not ready to go yet. Are you guys ready to go? I'm not ready to go. I think we should have a really cool little dance party at the beach before we leave. What do you think? All right, guys, that was our wonderful, wonderful field trip, virtual field trip, and I had so much fun, and I thank you very much for joining me today. I hope you also have fun. See you next time. Bye.